Welcome to Sex, Travel, Sports, Food with your host, Chk’n Cornbread. We about to get this joint in, man. You know what I'm saying? Straight on ANDS Radio. That's ain't no damn station radio. Because we ain't broadcasting on no station, man. We on your Wi-Fi. We on your hotspot. We on that T-Mobile, Cricket Wireless, Metro PCS, Verizon, and slow sprint to get this joint straight to you, man. And I'm going to be back to holler at y'all in a few seconds. But first of all, we're going to let Pac start this joint off. And y'all hang around, man. Hold up.
Follow me, tell me if you feel me. I think niggas is trying to kill me. Picturing pistols, spitting hollow points till they drill me. Keeping it real. And even if I do conceal my criminal thoughts, preoccupied with keeping still. See, niggas is false. Sitting in court, turn snitches. They used to be real. But now they petrified bitches. I'm trying to be strong. They sending armies out to bomb me. Listen to Ron. The only DJ that can calm me, constantly armed. My firepower keep me warm. I'm trapping the storm. And fuck the world till I'm gone. Bitches be warned. Word is born, you'll get torn. I'm busting on Giuliani, rubbing my niggas wrong. Ending this song, before I leave, picture me, I'm spitting that pump. Bitches and hustling to be free, watch me set it. Niggas don't want it, you can get it. Bet it, make these jealous niggas mad, I said it. This thug life, nigga, we don't cater to you hoes. Fuck with me, have 100 motherfuckers at your door with four foes. Yeah, nigga, thug life.
Man, Pa used to be going in on Bama's, man. But we gonna get right into it. And get straight to it, man. Sex, travel, sports, and food are basically the four things that I value in life. You know, clearly besides money. You need money for all that. You need money for to attain sex, travel, sports, and food, for real. So you can't, we not outside the realm of money. But outside of money, those are the only things that really matter. You know what I'm talking about? So we gonna, those are the things we're going to keep talking about on this particular podcast, and we're going to get it in. And so, you know, we're going to just go ahead and start off, man, you know, with sex, because Valentine's Day is coming up. You know, everybody out here. And what's Valentine's Day? Valentine's Day is a day made for Bammers to pay for sex, right? Or pay for sex that you already, either you already got the sex, or you're trying to get the sex. So that's what Valentine's Day is for. And, you know, you got to make sure you have your money right, because everything going to be prefixed menus. Everything going to be overpriced. The same flowers you bought initially. You know, if you would have bought these flowers like the week before, then you would have paid about 30% less. Right, 30-40% less for them same damn ass, them same flowers that's gonna die in 3 days, because you know y'all baby mamas and them don't know how to take care of the damn flowers. Let me stop playing. Now, I know y'all baby mamas cute or whatever, they know or whatever, they got a green thumb or whatever, but yeah, man, you know, I just think Valentine's Day is a silly ass quote unquote holiday, never Hallmark joint, but you know everybody done heard that same story. And that's how I feel about it. So I don't put a lot of effort into Valentine's Day, no matter what. I always disclose that up front, too. Like, in the first three dates, you make sure, if that's how you feel, that you tell the woman that. Because if she is one of those hopeless romantics and she wants to be extra on Valentine's Day and go through the drama and you ain't with it, then, you know, that's going to be a potential problem there. So you might as well just go ahead and disclose that off the top and let them know what you're doing and let them know how you feel about that, because it's only fair. You know what I'm saying? Just disclose that up front so she don't have her little feelings hurt. Calling a little girlfriend, whining, he not interested or whatever. Nah, he interested. He just ain't trying to waste his money, boo. Ain't nobody got time for wasting all this money out here. I go ahead and cook you something at the house. And we go ahead and watch this fire stick. Get this fire stick in this dude. That's basically how that's going to go. And ain't nothing wrong with that. You know, and then because a lot of ladies try to offer pussy for presents, right, for Valentine's Day. And pussy is not a present. It's not a gift. I guess if he hasn't had any pussy from you, then maybe that could be considered a gift for Valentine's Day. You know, you could wrap a little bow around your little cooch or whatever. Put a little bow on your forehead or whatever you're going to do. But in general, if he's already had sex with you, then nah, shawty. Nah, that's not fair. Then I'll be taking, you ain't never paid nothing about this. You ain't paid that Ruth Chris bill with none of this pussy. You ain't paid for the Uber with the pussy. You ain't paid for the hotel room or the whatever y'all at with the pussy. Nothing has been paid for with the pussy from that man's point of view. He broke. He spent real live dollars. Real, like, currency. Fiat. Now, I guess that's the new term because everybody on Bitcoin and cryptocurrency now. So he spent real live fiat on all this stuff. And you going to turn around and try to give him some pussy. That's disrespectful. You've been fucking for 20 years, right? And you trying to give him pussy. Recycle pussy. That it, some other motherfuckers that had that same gift. Oh, re-gifting ass. y'all going to stop that shit in 2018. Ain't, pussy is not a present, period. Just don't do it. Take that out of your plans. Do not dress up talking about, oh, you going to get this pussy tonight and happy Valentine's Day. No. That's cost avoidance, and we not going for it. I'm not allowing it to go. So don't start that shit, okay? Yeah, man. And then in that same vein, man, look, everybody, all the women are trying to make the guys feel like it's something wrong with them. If they trying to get one of these new 2018 sex dolls. Nah, shout it. Hey, look, the women have been having sex dolls, functional sex dolls. And what I mean by functional is it just be a big old dick, right? And they do whatever they want to. They done had that joint with that the man with the lower half of his abs and just a dick and like a half a thigh. Y'all know that little thing they can ride on? They done had that joke for years. And now they trying to get mad because the men got a new 2018 joke with the titties and the ass that jiggle and that talk because we got the robot now. Now they mad. That ain't fair. Y'all been fucking rubber fake dicks for hundreds of years. Now it's a problem. Now, he weird, he nasty, and then all the other little, I just learned this term recently, the other pick me dudes, right, the pick me's, they want to be on social media talking about, oh, yeah, any man that's into that is weird, and he don't get no real pussy, and blip, 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 blip. Y'all ain't say that to your girl when she got the King Dong 2000 in the closet with the double-edged dick. Y'all ain't say that then. That old fake plastic shit ain't real. She still get dick. She still, you know, y'all ain't talk down on that. So don't talk down on these new people, man. Hey, fella, know your worth. You go out there and get you that sex doll. You work hard for your money. You work hard to, you know, have a nice sex doll. Don't talk back. You don't need to take her out for Valentine's Day. All that good stuff. You get one. If that's what you want with your life, don't feel bad. Don't let nobody talk down to you about it. So you get that. Tell everybody close their mouth. And you name her. Pick out her color, hue, big titties, fat ass, whatever you want. You get that customized shit. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Shit. Y'all get that joints, man. Don't let them make you feel bad. So y'all get out there, man. Get your sex dolls on. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Plus, you ain't got to worry about no STDs. That's very important these days because they out here. You know, shit. Everybody got one at the end of the day. It's real live out here, man. And one disturbing thing I've been seeing lately is, you know, there's a lot of grown people on social media that will reveal their ineptness with sexual transmitted diseases and how you get them and how they're transmitted and all that stuff. A lot of people think that only people who are quote unquote nasty or hoes get sexually transmitted diseases. Like, I've seen this 3 times in the past, like, week. I've seen people online declaring that, you know, basically, if you get an STD, it's your fault because you should have known because the chick or the dude was nasty, or he was a community dick, or he was a whatever, right? And you're like, well, nah, that's not really accurate. It don't really work like that. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people who can get STDs and transport STDs and can be carriers. They don't even know. So you ain't got to be nasty or whatever. You might have got set up. Maybe the person that gave it to you ain't know, or vice versa, whatever it is. But to assume that the only reason you are at risk is because you are unable to identify somebody as being nasty or a hoe is the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. And this is why STDs are getting transferred at the rate they are, because these motherfuckers out here thinking, oh, if the pussy or the dick look clean from the outside, or if it don't have a smell or some shit, then they all set. And I'm trying to tell y'all, these people out here out of line, man. This is why the CDC puts out those little pamphlets with the cartoons on that shit. Right? The little bubbles, the little cartoons and squares and triangles and starfish and shit. Because these motherfuckers are really believing that you can identify some shit by looking at it. And that's just not how life works, dog. Y'all need to go to a sex education class and pull your life together. And stop doing that shit, man. For real. Y'all just stop it. Anyway, I'm going to stop preaching about STDs and shit. But that's like a real live situation for me. Like a real live situation that I think people need to focus on. And you know, it's hard, man. Because especially like somewhere in D.C., all these metropolitan places, everybody young with money out here, having fun, fucking whatever. Hey, man. Sometimes it be hard because you be like, man, this don't look good. And then, you know, but just like me and my man used to say, you know, she looked too good. Something wrong with her, man. We be like, man, if she looked too good, we always had to put something on. Like, man, she looked good, but she probably got something. You know what I'm saying? Something wrong with her. She can't look that good and not have something, or not have a problem or whatever. That was mean and ridiculous, but it happened. But, yeah, man. So, anyway, on the travel, I spent too much time on sex just now, but, you know, on the travel, man, make sure y'all get a passport out this joint for real. There's no reason in 2018, the age of the internet, social media, information age, that you should be without a passport, man. The world is huge. Huge, like your boy Donald Trump say. Ain't no way in the world you should be stuck to your little region or your neighborhood or your region of the world. Get out here, man. There's so much shit going on. Get a passport. That's really all I'm talking about today on travel, because there's a lot going on, man. You know what I'm saying? Just get out here, because they don't fuck with... If you black and you listen to this, get the fuck out of here, man. They don't like... Hey, look. America don't fuck with black people like that. Actually, nobody really fucks with black people like that. But you can at least be on a nice beach and they don't fuck with you. You understand what I'm saying? Or you can at least go see some good architecture in Italy or something, or Greece or Egypt or something. And they ain't fucking with you. But look, whatever. You stunting today, fuck it. Do something better. Not over here in this raggedy ass joint, man. In this shithole, like your boy said. But, yeah, get out of here, man. It's a big world. I'm going to try to get some people to come on. I like traveling. I'm going to have some guests come on and discuss their travel plans, travel trips, tips, different resources to use for you to get your travel game up. Stop going, you know, all that popping bottles. If I see... Y'all got to stop smoking all that damn hookah too, man. For real. I mean, it's cool. But I mean, that shit ain't lit like that. It ain't like that. It's okay. It's fun, social, whatever. But it ain't like that. You would think y'all motherfuckers, that I don't even know. It just be too much. Y'all be enjoying it a little bit, giving it a little bit too much importance. for the hookah. But anyway, man, then, you know, then in sports, man, look, fuck them Patriots, man. That's what, I mean, I don't even really know what else to say. I'm so glad that they lost. I'm, like, so happy. This is the second happiest I've been about a Super Bowl since the Patriots lost to the Giants with the helmet catch. That joint was lit. And that joint was on my birthday. And usually the Super Bowl is around my birthday. My birthday is February 3rd. Y'all can always send me any kind of gifts. Starbucks gift cards. You can send that to cousincornbread@gmail.com. Or any other gift cards or stuff y'all want to send me, please send it. But anyway, so, yeah, so I'm so happy that the Patriots lost, man, because they so arrogant. Bill Belichick is arrogant. Brady's arrogant. Their fans are annoying as fuck and arrogant. So to see them lose is awesome, right? I went to school in Boston, and my homies from up there, man, you would think them motherfuckers been winning for centuries, but they haven't. They just started winning in the 2000s. And I always tell them, hey, dog, the NFL was out before 2000 for decades at that. Motherfuckers got multiple titles in other towns before the Patriots got one. And, you know, you can't take nothing away from that. They done dominated the past, like, 17 years, for real. You can't take that away, but I also was like, hey, let's keep it real. Y'all probably didn't even know that y'all had a football team before the Tuck rule. You know what I'm talking about? Like, I don't even think nobody really knew who the Patriots were before that. But, and that's what made them famous. The Tuck rule. And then, Deflate Gate. The spy, you had Spy Gate. You got everything that the Patriots done won came with some kind of gate. These motherfuckers might as well be connected to Long Fence or some other motherfucking contractor or something that sell gates. Because all they do is get involved in some kind of shady shit and gates. But they still win them championships, though. And Tom Brady is a beast. He's overrated, but he is a beast. I don't like Tom Brady. I think he's overrated. And he's a Trump supporter. So those two things together, it just doesn't make him a likable figure, but he's a beast. He kind of like Kobe to me. I didn't really fuck with Kobe's attitude and his little snarl he had on his face all the time, that little asshole, whatever you want to call it, on his face. But if I'm starting a team, I probably going to put Kobe on my team. I ain't really like that with Brady, though. I put, like, two or three other quarterbacks on my team before I put Brady, if he was going to be the main guy. I fuck with Drew Brees or Aaron Rodgers. You know, they basically could do everything Brady do and more. You know, all his pre-read. He gets all his credit for pre-read snaps and all. I mean, I'm sorry, pre-snap reads and all that shit. But I mean, there's tons of guys that can do that and have better physical attributes. Like my man, Aaron Rodgers. But anyway, I'm so happy that they lost, man. Shout out to the Eagles fans. Y'all Pigeons finally got it done after all these years. And low-key, the Pigeons have been good for years. They just never could get it together. Right? Like, you know, the Pigeons basically have dominated. The Pigeons and the Midgets, the Giants, they've been basically dominating the NFC East for the past 15, 20 years, whole time. You know, you couldn't tell a Cowboys fan that, but yeah, the Eagles and the Giants have been dominating that division. You know, my former team, the Redskins, you know, they be in there now and then. They ain't been doing shit the past 20 years either. But anyway, shout out to the Pigeons, man. Pigeons fans gonna be lit for the next season or so. They ain't gonna get back, but that was good. Congratulations to them, man. Real. And and adios to Kirk Cousins. Hey, I'm so glad he's gonna get up out of here, man. Cause these local sports writers make that boy seem like he is the next Joe Montana or somebody. You would think he Aaron Rodgers till y'all see him play against Aaron Rodgers. Or even y'all seen him play against Carson Wentz or any of these other quarterbacks who really be getting it in that they want him to be. So I'm glad he's going to get out of here. Welcome, Alex Smith. And we'll see what happened with that, man. So what else, man? Look, shit. Oh, then we got food as my last top four things that matter in life. You know, I got diagnosed with diabetes last year. I had always been pre-diabetic. They finally go in ahead and gave, you know, made me fully diabetic, I guess. So, well, I don't know. Post-diabetic? I don't know the fuck. Anyway, whole point is, fuck all that. Food is awesome. And sweet food is even better. And carbs are awesome. So I think it's a whole big scam, man, because basically everybody out here be having diabetes. And it runs people's families. And I didn't even know that. My grandmother told me after the fact, oh, yeah, you know, everybody in our whole goddamn family got. Like, how come you ain't tell me that, grandma? Like, you should have told me. Like, long time ago, we should have put that in the play when I was growing up. Like, oh, you know, everybody got diabetes, so maybe we shouldn't let cornbread eat the damn honey buns and shit and get all excited about honey buns and Cinnabons and cake and all this shit through his whole life. Now I got this whole situation I can't even reverse. You know what I'm saying? I can't discontinue my love for cake. The fuck, what are we talking about right now? Cake is awesome. Everybody else be eating cake just fine. Now I can't like cake no more because I got that. Because they diagnosed me with diabetes or the sugar. But yeah, man, this shit is a scam, shawty. And then they give you these pills, and the pills fuck you up. It's just too much, man. Look, if I die like another year or whatever early, I don't care. Fuck it. I'm going to eat this motherfucking cake. I'm going to eat this bun and cheese. I'm going to eat whatever, man. I try to watch it, though, for real. For real, not being, stop talking shit, but I try to watch it, man. I do. I done switched up my diet a little bit. Take out shit here and there, but all good things, all things that taste good are bad for you, basically, is what it comes down to. Don't nobody like no fucking all this vegan shit and no meat and no carbs and no nothing. You just be depressed. You can only be rich and do all that shit because you can distract yourself with other great things for your sensories, right? You can go spend money on shit and buy shoes and clothes and trips and all kinds of shit that will give you those endorphins that a slice of chocolate cake would for me. You know what I'm talking about? Shit. You can't just be sitting over here going to your whack-ass dead-end job, sitting in D.C. traffic and talking to these dumb-ass people at work and the dumb-ass people on the train and about to fight everybody in traffic and all this shit and then come home and eat some celery. Are we fucking serious? Are we serious today? Nah. I'm not rushing home to eat no goddamn vegan chicken spelled with no I. How the hell are you gonna spell chicken ain't got no I's in it? Chicken, C-H-C-K apostrophe fucking N. Are we serious? Stop that shit, man. Nah, I'm gonna come home. I'm gonna eat me a goddamn steak, potatoes, cake, sweet tea, all those good things in life. Cause that's gonna make you feel better about how fucked up the world is. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta eat good food, man. And I'm gonna start tracking. I do a lot of reviews on Yelp. So y'all go follow me on Yelp too, man. I write up reviews about restaurants around here. I got some friends that actually are foodies who do tours. They done started a brunch tour in one of these groups I'm in. So we're gonna be talking about a lot of food stuff too, man. But this food, eat that shit and try to do something else. I go to the gym a lot to try to counteract some of the fuckery I be eating. And I know that's just a bad plan. But it's working for me so far. You know what I'm saying? I keep my little numbers down and all that shit. But I'ma get better. But right now, I just trying to ball out on these cinnamon rolls. That's just, you know, shit. I'm making that choice. The choice is mine. Look, if motherfuckers don't have to choose a gender no more, I don't have to choose to accept diabetes. Okay? I'm just going to self-identify as a non-diabetic. How about that? Be me outside, goddamn. Catch me outside. Tell me fuck I'm supposed to be doing, man. But anyway, I'm over the joint rambling. Might do some little, I'm going to do some giveaways. I know a lot of people, man. I'm going to be doing some giveaways. So when y'all listen to these joints, I'm going to have y'all go ahead and I'm going to do some kind of contest or something like that. So I'll be having some coupons, some little event invites, VIP joints and all that stuff, the little food events around the area, little tastings and shit. Probably some travel joints too. I know a bunch of travel agents that be out here trying to get this travel money. So maybe we can get something with that too. I'm going to think about it. Hey, whole time, I can't get y'all no coupons or Groupons or nothing like that on sex. But with that food and travel, I think I probably got you. Probably even on some sports tickets at some point. Shit, so we're going to see what's popping, man. But I'm about to wrap this joint up. I appreciate y'all for listening to this first episode of Sex, Travel, Sports, and Food with your host, Chk’n Cornbread. I'm Chk’n Cornbread on every social media platform, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud, whatever it is. Make sure y'all checking me out, man. Share this episode with your friends. Keep listening, keep supporting. I appreciate everybody out there. Till next time, log out.